day 25 of Tales from West Gardner, Maine. We're in the heart of West Gardner right now at the Mashes. John's splitting wood and Judy about to go make some biscuits. See? She's the biscuit lady. Best biscuit maker in Maine and beyond. Anyway, it reminds me of a story. A couple of fellows went fishing. Well, Maine boys may not be able to outfish each other, but they can out-talk each other, or I can at least try. Well, they went fishing remote ponds, stayed in the cabin, went in different directions, spent the day fishing, came back that night, settled down in the cabin, and the first fellow says, "Hey, I did pretty good today." "Oh, really? What'd you get?" "Well," he said, "I caught a 3-foot salmon." "Really?" the first fellow said. "Really? A 3-foot salmon. Good for you." He said, "You know what I caught? Something wicked heavy. I caught a big cast iron stove. Took me a while to drag it out of the lake, and when I finally did, there was still warm biscuits in the oven." First fellow said, "You know, that's crazy. You didn't catch a stove, and there weren't no warm biscuits." He said, "I'll tell you what I'll do. You take 2 feet off that salmon, I'll give you two of them warm biscuits." That's storytelling in Maine. Yeah. Have yourself a great day, and be kind to each other. Distance, distance, distance. Yeah? Welcome to day 26 of Tales from West Gardner, Maine. Got cows for a backdrop today. Wicked sharp there. Got to tell you this story about what happened in West Gardner a few weeks ago. Jimmy Fuller was driving home late one night, about 2 o'clock in the morning, almost at house, a little tired. Mert Hickey was our constable at the time, and Jimmy pulls up to a stop sign and looks both ways. Couldn't see any traffic 2 o'clock in West Gardner in the morning. He eased on through, didn't quite stop at the stop sign, what you might call a California rolling stop. Well, as soon as he got through and started up the road, blue light come on. Mert Hickey was sitting there behind a bush, hiding. Pulled Jimmy over. Jimmy gave me his license and registration. He said, "What is the problem, Mert?" Mert said, "Well," he said, "you just ran that stop sign. I'm going to give you a ticket." "Really?" He said, "I did not run that stop sign. I stopped." He said, "No, you didn't. I watched you. You didn't come to a complete stop." Jimmy said, "Hey, I came that close to stopping. What's the difference between almost stopping like that and stopping? You tell me, Mert." Mert said, "Well, get out of the truck, Jimmy." Jimmy got out of the truck. Mert took out his nightstick and started slapping him side the head. Boom, boom, boom. He kept doing it. He said, "Hey, Jimmy, you want me to slow down or stop?" That's the difference between slowing down and stopping. Take care of each other. Keep separated. Be kind to each other. We'll get through this. Yeah? Welcome to day 27 of Tales from West Gardner, Maine. I'm right here at the town office, the fire station, and as you can see, annual town meeting has been postponed due to the virus. We'll get back to it, because that's a New England tradition. We all sit in folding metal chairs and do the town's business in one day. Just not this day. Aunt Edith done it again. Edith marched at the dentist's office the other day. She's kind of a cheapskate. She walked in, she said to the dentist, "How much is it gonna cost me to get an abscess tooth pulled?" He thought for me, he said, $200. I said, "Well, what if I do it without Novocaine? Ooh, it's gonna hurt, but I could knock $50 off, it'd be $150. What if that assistant dentist that you've got, what if he did it? He's just learning, but he's pretty good, I think. Ooh, with no Novocaine, it's gonna hurt, but only cost you $100. All right, what if the dental hygienist did it with no Novocaine? Wow, you'd have to be strapped down. I don't care about the pain. I'm telling you, we gotta save some money here. All right, if the hygienist did it, oh, $50. You know that new receptionist you've got, been here about a week? She looks like she's got strong forearms. She can handle it. What if she pulled a tooth with no Novocaine with you just watching? Ouch, she said. That's going to hurt so bad I'd almost sell tickets for people to watch. Oh, I don't care about the pain. Just tell me how much it's going to cost. Well, if you will let my receptionist pull that tooth with no Novocaine, $5. Okay, great. I'll have my husband come in on Tuesday. Yeah, hey, be kind to each other. We'll get through it.